A once Balloon Fiesta worker is still missing after taking off with thousands of dollars meant for the arts and crafts show tents. It's been 2 months. Action 7 News reporter Regina Reese is live. Regina.
Well, Royal, this mystery has cost these vendors big bucks. Take a look at this amazing metal art here. These Balloon Fiesta pieces are beautiful. Well, this vendor lost out on $4,000. Other vendors lost about $2,000. But no matter what, the organizer is gone, and so is their money.
It's a stone-on-stone, new vintage repoussé tooling.
Some of the finest artisans all in one place at Balloon Fiesta Park.
We're just lucky to be here and happy to be able to sell and show our work.
That lucky feeling comes from a scare over the summer. The woman who organizes the arts and crafts tent and collects thousands of dollars in booth fees took off, money and all.
Who knows what goes through people's heads? We just don't know.
Artists stopped hearing from the organizer, and so did Balloon Fiesta officials. The crafters worried about the fee payments they made and the lost income from the Balloon Fiesta.
Balloon Fiesta brings us revenue for the whole year. We literally get people calling back. My website gets lit up from the UK, from Europe, from England, from all over the world, and it's just really cool.
To help the artists out, Balloon Fiesta officials arranged for an arts and crafts tent and charged artists only a minimal fee. Now the artisans here hope the event stays in the hands of the Fiesta.
It makes us closer to what we should be doing. There's no middleman.
No middleman, and no possible repeat of what happened to artists this year. So as you heard there, all of these vendors are just happy to be here today. They're happy to be able to sell all of their stuff here at the Balloon Fiesta, and they just want to put this whole mystery, this whole ordeal, behind them. Reporting live tonight from Balloon Fiesta Park, Regina Reese, Action 7 News.
Okay, thanks, Regina. The Arts and Crafts Show is in the big white tent at the southwest corner of I-25 and Paseo del Norte.